Welcome back, our Facebook Live viewers. It's good to have you on board. Of course, we're at the Mitsubishi Big Show 2017, and we're up to our final rotation of the number 11s, thanks to Can-Am, our major supporters for this roping this week at the Big Show. And I tell you what, you're looking at getting times over two runs to give yourself a real shot at some big cash and prizes to be around that 14, 15 second mark. So really get down there, and you've got to throw it down, stretch them out, 7 seconds, that's what you're sort of shooting for, and do that over two runs, and you'll be sitting pretty heading into the short go and the top 30 round. So it will be a lot of fun, the number 11s, as we continue our sixth and final rotation here at the Mitsubishi Big Show 2017. We're about to roll around and get things started in the arena for rotation six. All right, as we head out to the paddock, it's Ben Smith and Troy Lomax will be getting us started. Troy supported in the third party by Troy Lomax Farrier Services. Ben Smith is under Troy Lomax Farrier Services, my correction. Troy Lomax supported by All West Concreting Services. Just to be a little confusing, we're at draw number 172. This is the numbers that are starting rotation six this morning. Thanks to Can-Am for the number 11's roping. We've got the head loop out and on. Dally's on, turns back the steer nicely, throws it down, throws it under, picks up 1 foot. 7.26 plus 5 with the 1 foot. That'll be a 12.26 officially on the books from our timekeepers as we go to Peter Hutchins and Shane Kenny. Peter supported in the third party by Mike Hutchins, followed by Michael Brogan and Adam Maher. Roping at three will be Dan Hoskins and Greg Lees. Roping at four will be Jesse Townsend and Jason McPhee. Roping at five, Sue Parker and Jai Robson. Roping at six, Gail Sharp and Brenton Bell. And roping at seven, Thomas and Murray Whitwell. Yeah. All right, we'll just get some preparations. Peter Hutchins just trying to square things up in the box on the head side. Emerald-based cowboy. It's an emerald team, this one. Peter Hutchins, Shane Kenny. Head loops out and on. Shane shoots from the hip, pulls up a pair. Clean on the run. 6.12 officially. Nice way to start that pairing, Peter Hutchins and Shane Kenny. As we go to Michael Brogan and Adam Maher. Followed by Dan Hoskins and Greg Lees. Roping third will be Jesse Townsend and Jason McPhee. What was that asterisk for? All right, throws down the heel trap, waits, but empty. No time on the run for Brogan and Maher. Dan Hosking and Greg Lees, our next team to go. Greg supported by his horseshoeing business in the third party. Following this team, we'll see Jesse Townsend and Jason McPhee. Roping at three will be Sue Parker, heading one for Jai Robson. Roping at four, Gail Sharp and Brenton Bell. Roping at five, Thomas and Murray Whitwell. All right, Dan Hosking's going to chase one down, turn you back a steer. It's going to come up empty on the head loop. It'll be a no time officially on the books for run number one on their rotation six effort. Jesse Townsend, Jason McPhee next to go. Of course, we do have some hides, compression hoods up for grabs. If you happen to draw a bounty steer, for those that have just joined us on the Facebook Live feed in this number 11s, if they're sub 8 seconds, if they draw that bounty, they can pick that up for the header and heeler team, just as a nice little bonus. As Jesse Townsend, Jason McPhee, stretch them out. They're clean on the run, 7.17. Sue Parker, Jai Robson. Sue supported in the third party by Tagulawa Saddlery. Gail Sharp, Brenton Bell, you'll follow this team in the box. Roping at three will be Thomas and Murray Whitwell. Roping at four, Norm Stagg and Joe Birch. And roping at five, Glenn Perkins and Wayne Slater. Sue Parker sets herself for the head loop, throws it out, gets it on. Turns back down the back end of the paddock. Jai sets the heel trap but comes up empty on this occasion. No time. Gail Sharp and Brenton Bell, our next team. We're at 178 in the box here at the Can-Am, number 11 roping, at the Mitsubishi Big Show 2017. Following the team in the box, we'll see the Whitwells, Thomas and Murray pair up, father and son. Roping at three will be Norm Stagg and Joe Birch. Gail Sharp sets herself for the head loop. The Dally's on. All right, Brenton Bell, catch yourself a pair on the back end. It's not going to work. Comes up empty. No time on the run. No change on the books. Thomas and Murray Whitwell, our next team to go. We're draw number 179. As we continue, the Can-Am number 11s at the Mitsubishi Big Show 2017. Of course, if you've just joined us on the Facebook Live, like us. Let us know you're enjoying the footage. Thanks to Big Screens Australia. Share it with your friends too so they can link up as we get 1 foot in the field. 8.54 plus 5. That'll be a 13.54 officially on the books for the Whitwells, the father and son pairing. Norm Stagg and Joe Birch, our next team to go. Norm supported by his fencing business in the third party. Glenn Perkins, Wayne Slater will rope following this team. Roping at three will be William Thompson and Aaron Bookluck. Roping at four, Michael Reynolds and Andrew McWalter-White. Roping at five, Billy Guilford and Josh Symes. As the head loop goes out and down to the ground, it'll be a no time for the Stagg and Birch combination. Glenn Perkins, Wayne Slater. Couple of veteran cowboys. Very competitive in the team roping competition. Around we go. Wayne sets himself for the heel trap. Waits. Pulls up a pair. Clean is the signal from Trey Johnson, our flag judge. 9.32 on the run. Of course, Trey Johnson, our Weatherford, Texas cowboy, our flag judge for the big show for the number 11s. He will be showing his word in cowboy ministry over the lunch period today at the big show. If you get a chance to join us, please do so. It'll be down around the 7 area of the seating tiers. William Thompson and Aaron Bookluck. William, supported by Southeast Vets Mount Gambier, goes out with a no time. Michael Reynolds and Andrew McWalter-White, our next team to go. Michael Reynolds, supported in the third party by Mick Reynolds Custom Saddles. Following this team will be Billy Guilford and Josh Symes. Roping at three, Jacob and Todd Gaffey. Roping at four will be Tamara Knox and John Osborne. Roping at five, Mick Hockley and Warren Norton. All right, we're at 183 in the paddock. Head loops on, round the corner we go. Shoots from the hip but comes up empty. No time on the run as we go to 184 in the box. It's Billy Guilford and Josh Symes. Thanks to Guilford Transport supporting both competitors on this run. Jacob and Todd Gaffey will follow at 185. Roping at 3, 186. Tamara Knox and John Osborne. Roping at 4 will be Mick Hockley and Warren Norton at 187. And roping at 5, 188, David Corr with Dale Caban. The head loop goes out and on, throws down the heel trap, but comes up empty. It will be no time for Billy Guilford and Josh Symes. Jacob and Todd Gaffey next to go. As we continue the Can-Am number 11 roping here at the Mitsubishi Big Show. Big thanks to Navajo Trailers for their incentive bonus. Nice little horse floats up for grabs. Peel Tribe and the team from out of Warwick, Queensland. All right, this is the Gaffeys in action, Jacob and Todd. Todd throws down the heel trap, picks up a pair on the back end, 9.74. Tamara Knox and John Osborne. John supported by Evandale Arena Productions. Next to go, we're at 186 in the draws. So we burn a steer. Followed by Mick Hockley and Warren Norton. Roping at three will be David Corr and Dale Caban. Roping at four will be Bill Willoughby and Alan Wood. And roping at five, 190, Tony Hallam and Bruce Birch. All right, Tamara Knox pairs up to with Johnny Osborne, Evandale Arena Productions. Keep the likes coming for our Facebook Live viewers. Let us know where you're viewing from. We'll say g'day. All right, just having a little hiccup with our barrier. We'll get that fixed up. Mechanical malfunction, I guess they call that. Of course, our barrier judge, professional champion cowboy, John Brealey. Oh, we got some Tassie viewers. It's good to have you on board this morning on Facebook Live. Nice little additive for the 2017 Big Show event here at the beautiful Alex Stadium. One of a kind here in Australia. All right, Katie Upton is cheering for Tamara. Well, the head loop goes down to the ground. No time on the run for the Knox Osborne combination. Mick Hockley and Warren Norton, our next team in the box. We're at 187 in the draws in rotation six, run number one. This is our final rotation for the number 11s before we finalise. So top five in each rotation come back. And the top 10 extra. So top 40 is where they're trying to vie for. As Mick Hockley and Warren Norton go out with an O time. David Corr and Dale Caban is our next team. We're at 188 in the box, followed by Bill Willoughby and Alan Wood. Roping at three will be 190, Tony Hallam and Bruce Birch. Roping at four, Clint and Heath Litchfield at 191. Roping at five, Jeff Miller will pair up with Darcy Kirsch. All right, David Corr on the head side, Dale Caban on the heels. Throws it out, puts it on. We're halfway there. Come on, Cabes. Well, unlucky with the heel trap today. So we roll up a bounty steer, a chance to win a Hides compression hood. Thanks to Brooke Mapp behind Hides, the products locally. It's the bounty for the number 11. It's got to be a sub-8-second run. Bill Willoughby and Alan Wood have the chance to do that. Bill supported in the third party by his business name. Willoughby Way Horsemanship, one of the best horsemen in Australia, really does have the four-legged friend figured out. Alan Wood, supported in the third party by his livestock business out of Griffith, New South Wales. Floats it down, but comes up empty on the run. No time, no luck for the Willoughby Wood combination. Tony Hallam and Bruce Birch next to go, followed by Clint Litchfield and Heath together. Keep it in the family. We're at 190 in the box. 192, you'll run third, Jeff Miller and Darcy Kirsch. Roping fourth, Ella Mitchell and Jace Land at 193. Right down the back end of the paddock, throws down the heel trap but comes up empty for the Hallam-Birch combination. It is a no time. Clint and Heath Litchfield next to go. Clint supported in the third party by Litchfield Horizontal Boring. Jeff Miller and Darcy Kirsch next to go, following this team in the box. Roping at three will be Ella Mitchell and Jace Land at 193. Roping at four, James Maguire Spaulding and David Brown. Roping at five, Mick Carney and Campbell Hodson at 195. This is shout out to Hanley Bridge in South Australia. Good to have you on board today on Facebook Live. As our team of the Litchfields go out with a no time, Clint and Heath. Unlucky on the run. As we go to Jeff Miller and Darcy Kirsch. Both these competitors did well last night in the Opens roping. Darcy normally prefers the head side. He's on the heels this time with the Miller from the with the Open roping champion last night, Jeff Miller. Darcy now floats it down, floats it under, comes up empty with the heel trap. It's a no time for Jeff Miller and Darcy Kirsch. Ella Mitchell and Jace Land next to go. We're at 193 in the draws in rotation six, run number one. Jace supported in the third party by Long Pocket Earth Moving as we roll up a bounty steer. Another chance to win a Hides compression hood thanks to Brooke Mapp, the local distributor for the products. Got to be better than 8 seconds to get that bonus, but let's get a catch regardless. Jay sets himself round the corner, floats it down, but comes up empty with the heel trap. It is no time on the books for draw number 193. 194 to enter the box now. James and Maguire Spalding and David Brown as a pair. Following will be Mick Carney and Campbell Hodson. Roping at three will be 196, Malcolm Fishenden and Andrew Lynch. Roping at four, Clint Vandenbroek and Clinton Slater at 197. And roping at five, Gene Hinkst and Dusty Tatum. As the head loop goes out and on for James and Maguire Spalding, David Brown sets himself for the trap and picks up two toenails. It's clean in the field, 7.21. 7.21 on the run. 6.12, the fast time in the rotation so far in this first round effort. As we go to Mick Carney and Campbell Hodson, we're at 195 in the box. Mick supported in the third party by NCI. Floats it out, picked up a little bit more than he bargained for, lets it go. Malcolm Fishenden, Andrew Lynch. Next team, Andrew supported in the third party by Red River. Big thanks, of course, Red River Rural supporting our ground team as well. About a dozen to run. Just a heads up to our Red River Rural team. Head loops out and on, around the corner we go. Andrew Lynch sets the trap, picks up one, five in the field, 9.76 plus five. 14.76 on the books officially for Malcolm Fishenden and Andrew Lynch. As we go to Clint Vandenbroek and Clinton Slater, our next team, we're at 197 in the draws in the number 11 roping, thanks to Can-Am here at the Mitsubishi Big Show 2017. Gene Hinkst and Dusty Tatum, you'll follow. Roping at three will be Wendy Caban with Peter Todd Sr. All right, as we chase one out, the head loops out and on. Clinton Slater now sets himself for the trap. Pulls up a pair on the back end. They got five at the line. It's 11.2 plus five. Gene Hinkst and Dusty Tatum, our next team to go. Dusty supported in the third party by DSA. We're at 198 in the draws in the number 11's roping. Following this team will be Wendy Caban and Peter Todd Sr. Roping at three, Alex Campbell and Matthew Mapp at 200. Roping at four at 201, Casey Tribe will head one for Steve Sutherland. And roping at five, 202, Natalie and Heath Kimber. As the head loop goes out and on, Dusty Tatum on the back end comes up empty on this occasion. No time on the run for the Hinkston-Tatum combination. Wendy Caban and Peter Todd Sr. next to go. Peter supported by his equine services business in the third party. Let's get out and get one on. If you've just joined us on Facebook Live, it's good to have you on board. Let us know where you're watching from as our team 199 go out with a no time. Alex Campbell and Matthew Mapp, our next team to go, followed by Casey Tribe and Steve Sutherland. Roping at three will be 202, Natalie and Heath Kimber. Roping at four, 203, Tony Lilliman and Paul Hunkin. And roping at five, 204, Adam Bates with Liam Davison. All right, Alex Campbell will just get the arena cleared. Floats it out, the head loop's a good one. We're halfway there. Shoots from the hip, misses the dally. What would have been, could have been, is not to be for the Campbell and Mapp combination. No time on their first round run in rotation six. Casey Tribe and Steve Sutherland will get this arena cleared first before our next run. Just hold up. Casey supported by his equine dentistry business in the third party. Following the team in the box, it'll be 202, Natalie and Heath Kimber. Roping at three, 203, Tony Lilliman and Paul Hunkin. Roping at four will be Adam Bates and Liam Davison. Roping at five, Gary King and Lee Kimber. Just eight teams remaining. Just a heads up to our Red River Rural ground team. Doing a wonderful job all week. Just about set, Casey Tribe. Fresh back from knee surgery, around the corner we go. The rope sticks, Steve Sutherland sets for the heel trap. Tries to get him off the fence. Looks like he's got a toenail. We've got 1 foot, 9.57 plus five. All right, Natalie and Heath Kimber, our next team. We're at 2:02. Big thanks for Lynchy and the team. Red River Rural supplying all our lead-up crush and panels. Really do appreciate the ongoing support. They've been with us since day dot at the big show. We really do appreciate it on the local front. All right, just as a heads up, if anybody's interested, the lead-up crush will be going up for auction tonight if anyone is interested. Thanks to Red River Rural. So Heath Kimber sets himself on the back end, picks up 1 foot. It's five in the field, 8.04 plus five for Natalie and Heath Kimber. So we go to Tony Lilliman and Paul Hunkin. Tony supported in the third party by Cattle Creek Company, along with Paul Hunkin as well. We're at 2:03 in the box. Just six teams to go to finalise run number one of rotation six of the Can-Am number 11's roping. On day number two of the Mitsubishi Big Show, right down the back end of the paddock, we're going to do a little fishing. Picks up 1 foot on the back end, a plus five on a time of 11.97 plus five, a 16.97 with the penalty inclusive. Adam Bates and Liam Davison, our next team. Bates supported by Brett Peel Equine. Liam supported by HD Helicopters in the third party. Liam a big winner last night when he paired up with Jeff Miller in the Opens. Picked up a few nice checks in that short go in the Opens roping. Warmed up for the rest of the weekend as he shoots from the hip, picks up a pair. 6.65 for the Bates-Davison combination. I believe it's a 6.12, still the fast time in the round. Peter Hutchins and Shane Kenny with four teams to go to wind down their first run effort in rotation six. Gary King and Lee Kimber. Gary supported by Tasman Horse Transport. And Tasmanian competitor in with the Lockington Victorian champion. They come up empty on the run though, unfortunately. Joe Raines and Brody Moss next to go. We're at 2:06, just three teams to wind down run number one of rotation six. Following Joe and Brody, we'll see Roger York and Pete Salter and Dally Tills and Robbie White Jr. will be our final pairing. 2:06, 2:07, 2:08. That's where we're at in rotation six, run number one. All right, Joe Rain's going to chase one down. Floats out the head loop. It's not going to stick. It will be no time for Joe Raines and Brody Moss. Brody supported in the third party by Jay Slade. Roger York and Pete Salter next to go. All right, Roger York, Pete Salter. Ducking and dive, lined him out nicely, but unfortunately come up empty. No time on the run. Dally Tills and Robbie White Jr., our final team for run number one in rotation six. The fast time in the round for run number one in rotation six, held by Pete Hutchins and Shane Kenny. The Emerald-based combination in Queensland. Ladies and gentlemen, they've came from all over the country and across the pond of the Pacific Ocean to be here at the Mitsubishi Big Show. All right, Dally had to set things up again. Little hiccup as he left the box, but things are okay now. Floats it down, floats it under the heel side. Hit five in the field, 11.34 plus five. All right, that wraps up. That wraps up run number one of rotation six in the Can-Am number 11's roping here at the Mitsubishi Big Show. Shortly, we'll cross down to Sean O'Hanlon, but right now, let's get a word from our sponsors. Thanks to Big Screens Australia.
Hey, well, welcome everybody out there in Facebook land here to the Mitsubishi Big Show Team Roping Championships of 2017. We're currently halfway through round number two of the number sixes rotation of the number 11's roping. And I've got with me here two great team ropers in Australia's history. I'm just going to ask a few questions to the one and only Shane Kenny at this stage. Shane, you've got a lot of cattle here that are contracted to the event. Just tell everybody out there just what goes into breeding and owning this many cattle and to stand them up, because the quality of livestock here this week is just phenomenal, and it's an absolute credit to you.
Yeah, about a month ago, I guess, we got went down to Gympie and mustered our cattle and brought them home and put them on the grain bin so that they had a bit of grain in them, and tipped all their horns and, you know, just had a good look over them, any eyes were sore or whatever, and clean them up and give them some vitamin shots and all that sort of thing, and pre-dip them because we had to dip to come down here. So all that sort of stuff knocks them around a little bit. So we got to, make sure that they're strong and healthy, and then we worry about how they run and all that sort of thing. And we tried to draft everyone's cattle up so that everyone's steers were, you know, fairly similar, and give all the ropers a good go at it.
Yeah, great. Mate, you've had a little change professionally lately in the last few months regarding your work-wise. So now it would appear that you're on the road more now than possibly what you have been in the last 10 years. We would probably think that you're spending a lot more time in the practice pen, but you're probably busier now doing other things with all your cattle than what you ever were. But, mate, you're still roping as hot as anybody. You were the fastest team back last night into the finals of the Open with Trey Johnson. You ended up with the reserve champion in the Opens competition. How's your roping been going here this week throughout the 11s and the Opens, and are you happy with your loop at the moment?
Yeah, just treat it one steer at a time. That's all you can pretty much do. Can't dwell on the past and look to the future. So, it's been good. But, we've been fortunate. We've been contracting a lot of rodeos down in New South Wales and Victoria, and so it's sort of taking our main focus, what we're doing at the moment, and having a second childhood going rodeo on again, so it's been really good. But loving life here.
Well, once again, it's our great pleasure to have you along. I mean, you've won a Mitsubishi motor car here in previous years, you've won some saddles, you've won lots and lots of cash, so it's our pleasure to have you here on behalf of the Big Show, and thank you very much for the cattle, mate. They're a credit to you and your family, and they're an integral part of the success of the Big Show, so thanks very much. It's great to have you along. Standing to my right, ladies and gentlemen, is one of the masters of Australian team roping. He's roped with many of the best all over the world. He's joined us here for the first time this year at the Big Show. Hasn't been here yet due to other work commitments and different things that he's been putting together in the last couple of years. But I'd like to introduce everybody to the one and only Johnny Osborne Jr. Johnny, as I said, you've roped with the best of the best all over the world. You've won all the big ropings. You've won numerous Australian titles in many associations at the highest division. You've been a stalwart of the sport. You're absolutely entertaining to watch. Up there on the microphone, we tell people to make sure they get a chance to watch Johnny Osborne rope. Mate, tell us about your thoughts on where team roping's come in Australia in the last, say, 10-year period.
Oh, look, it's advanced so much. The thing that I notice the most these days compared to when 20 years ago and, you know, even 10 years ago when we were rodeoing and roping a lot is that today the younger generation has such an advantage by social media. So you've got all the technology, you can get on there, you can join total team roping, you can join the X Factor roping thing. So to have the instructors that you can just send a video to and they can look at it and send you back a message, say, hey, work on this, work on that. Whereas when we kind of started out, it was just us guys and we never had a lot of people to give us a lot of help. So to go through how it is today with everyone having the opportunity, even the training devices today, like you've got all these roping dummies, and they're just exceptional. Like you can get in there, you can work on your time, and you can work on going, making slow, smooth runs on the dummies, which makes practice so good. We used to just have to back in there and run steers after steers, and that's what it was like. But the team roping has advanced so much, I think, more on the healing side. And having a few years away from competition and then coming back and getting to see the younger guys and so many guys healing good back when it was just a couple of us that healed good, we kind of stood out a little bit because there was a couple of us could catch a lot of steers by 2 feet. Now you get in there and you have to rope steers by 2 feet, but you got to rope steers fast by 2 feet. And these younger guys are putting the pressure on the older guys, and it just makes you want to step up. And I've just got back into it. I've just got back into practicing and doing a little bit, but the advancement in the healing side, I believe, has come a long way. And it's a credit to Wayne and that, to putting on these events and the ATRA for putting on all the ropings we get to go to. Like, we never had jackpots. We got to go to rodeos, and that was our deal. So for the younger guys to come along and learn how to catch, learn how to set runs up and be consistent, then they can advance, get faster, and they can step up to the rodeo level. So it's come a long way. It has, really, really has.
Yeah, it certainly has. Mate, at your stage of your career now, looking back on the 30-odd years you've probably spent going down the road and travelling the world, thinking that about that and keeping that in mind, here shortly today we're going to move into the number eights roping with a lot of the lower numbered ropers. And a lot of those younger people, men and women, there's a lot of girls here roping this year, which is great. There's a lot of young kids coming up through the junior ranks. They watch the likes of you and Shane and Jeffrey and Heath Litchfield and those fellas that have won numerous titles in Australia. There's so much detail involved in putting a good team roping run together. It's easy for the young team roper to fight his or her head over how they get to that level. What's a quick word of advice that you might give to those young people that are really studying hard? They're using the technology that's out there. They're trying to get to the practice pen a lot. What's a mindset that you might suggest to those young people to keep as they're trying to progress through the ranks?
It doesn't matter what level you get to. Like, when you're starting out and you're a beginner and you're starting to just come into the roping world, the biggest thing you got to learn to do is be consistent. And I think sometimes people just get in speed jams all the time. People just want to rope fast all the time. The only way you get consistently fast is you got to start out slow. So you got to start out learning to catch. And the best advice I can give to everyone in the eight ropings and stuff is just set your shots up. Set your runs up. Get to your cow. Don't panic when you get to your cow. Like, get there, get a good look at him when you're heading, get it on him, make sure you get dallied, make your horse go out of there. And same with the heelers. Let them steers get away from him and ride to him and cover him up a jump or two and get a good look at him. And it doesn't matter if you're in the number eight roping or you're roping in the eight roping, and in the open roping, sorry. It all comes down to still catching two horns and 2 feet. And if you make consistent runs, whether it's being 12 or 15 in the number eights on each one, or having to be 6 or 7 in the other one, it's the same deal. We just do it a little bit faster. We set shots up a little bit faster. But coming up through the ranks, you got to slow down, learn to catch. If you can learn to catch and make consistent runs, speed will come to you. But the minute you try to force issues is when you get yourself in trouble. And we're the same.
Yeah, there you go. There you go. Well, Johnny, it's been very exciting for all of us that learnt that you were going to join us here this year. It's been great to have you along. How's about your own loop? Happy with it?
Not really. Like, it's pretty rusty still. Like, it was hard. I had a full shoulder reconstruction last year, and coming back for that and then staying away from it for a few years and then coming back to the level that everyone expects you to be at, and it's hard to get to practice. And when you're full-time working, it's like, before when we were rodeoing and that's all we did, it was good, because that's all you did was practice. And that's what people got to look at. Like, to be great, you got to work at it, and you got to put in every single day. And that's the thing. We don't practice anymore. We don't get to put in like we'd want to put in. But to have a chance to come to this and come and rope, like, it's been really good, entertaining. I've enjoyed it. It's great catching up with everyone, having a bunch of fun. So it's good.
Oh, well, that's great. Well, there you are, ladies and gentlemen. Hey, don't forget to like and share us on Facebook. You've just heard from two of the greats of the industry. So thanks very much for joining us here at the Mitsubishi Big Show Team Roping Championships in Tamworth for 2017. Now I'm going to hand you back over to Big Screens Australia to hear from some of our great sponsors.
Well, thanks a lot, Sean O'Hanlon, Johnny Osborne, giving us some great advice for the sport of team roping. Competitors, if we could get you to clear the arena, we are about to get underway with run number 2 of rotation number 6 here at the Can-Am number 11's team roping, all part of the Mitsubishi Big Show 2017. It really has been a wonderful performance this morning, some very quick times. in this particular rotation. The fast time from the first run was 6.12. Peter Hutchins and Shane Kenny. There was some that were very, very close. So 6.65, Adam Bates and Liam Davison. They're definitely giving themselves a nice position. Looking forward to catching a second head, along with Jesse Townsend, Jason McPhee with a 7.17, a 7.21, James McGuire Spaulding, David Brown. So there has been a variety of fast times already posted in the Can-Am number 11 rotation 6 numbers as we continue. Just to give you an idea, ladies and gentlemen, Can-Am, the major supporter of the number 11's roping here at the big show. The short round, which will be decided, there's about 40 of them coming back by the time we finish this rotation, number 6. We'll get that all tallied out. We'll let you know those names and the numbers on the times that they are coming back on. There's some great prizes. Potentially, the header and heeler have a chance at winning a slice of $56,000 between them. It really is a fantastic event. And it's all part of the Mitsubishi Big Show. If you have just joined us on the Facebook live feed, make sure you like us, make sure you share it on your pages. And if you do have some questions, by all means, drop us a comment and we'll get back to you as soon as possible. My name's Larry Cann, alongside of my co-announcer, Mr. Sean O'Hanlon. We are really enjoying, thanks to Wham Promotions, this wonderful production at the beautiful Alex Stadium in Tamworth, New South Wales, the Australian Equine Livestock Event Centre. As we get started with Ben Lomax and Ben Smith and Troy Lomax. Well, Benny goes out with a head loop that goes to the ground. Ben supported by Troy Lomax Farrier Services and Troy supported by All West Concreting Services. No time in run number 2. They were 12.26 on their first run with a penalty inclusive. As we continue, the fast team in run number 1 was Emerald Queensland based team, Peter Hutchins and Shane Kenny. Peter supported in the third party by Mike Hutchins. They were 6.12. They need to get themselves a catch, get things started nicely with a head loop. Throws it out, floats it on, dallies up round the corner. Shane Kenny, oh, sweet as you like it. Pair on the back end, 7.48. That's going to be tough to beat in the aggregate. We'll get some numbers. I believe it's 13.6. 13.60 on 2. Very solid this morning. Peter Hutchins and Shane Kenny. All right, we're at draw number 174. Michael Brogan, Adam Marr. They were in no time. They need to be fast. Head loops on. Heel loop goes to the ground. It's a no time for the Brogan and Marr combination. Dan Hosking, Greg Lees next to go. Greg supported in the third party by Lees Horse Shoeing. And we have a bounty steer in the box, chance to win a Hyde's compression hood. Got to be sub 8 seconds to do so. Thanks to Brook Map, the local distributor for Hyde's products, and proudly supporting the Mitsubishi Big Show 2017. So we're at 175, ladies and gentlemen. For those that have joined us on Facebook Live, along with our friends here in the arena at the Alex Stadium, 176 will follow Jesse Townsend and Jason McPhee. Roping at 3 will be Sue Parker and Jai Robson at 177. Roping at 4, 178, Gail Sharp and Brenton Bell at 178. Tries to fish it on. Oh, like a bad fishing story. One gets away. No time. Jesse Townsend, Jason McPhee next to go. 7.17. Solid on run number 1 to be a mover and a shaker. Well, we had an interesting question on Facebook Live about the numbering system for the entries. It really is a computer random draw. It's computer generated. It's printed out, and that's how we roll from the initial entries. So it's not just on how they call in and enter up as Jesse Townsend and Jason McPhee go to work. Well, unlucky for a team that had a solid time in run number 1, 7.17. Well, I'm going to hand things back over to Sean O'Hanlon. He's back from being down stretching the legs in the paddock and having some great interviews with some of our top stars coming through here at the big show. Over to you, Sean O'Hanlon.
Hey, thanks very much, Larry. There you are, ladies and gentlemen, back with round number 2 of the final rotation of the 11s, Sue Parker and Jai Robson. Sue proudly sponsored by the Tagulawa Saddlery.
Oh, goodness me. Just ran out of arena, unfortunately, there for Sue and Jai. No time on the board. Let's go to 178 in the draw. Gail Sharp and Brenton Bell. 179 will be Thomas and Murray Whitwell. 180 will be Norm Stagg and Joe Birch. And 181 will be Glenn Perkins and Wayne Slater. Gail Sharp nods ahead. Ran out of arena, unfortunately, there for her partner in Brenton Bell as well. Got themselves a fast steer to run straight and run true. Let's go back down to the box and look for Thomas and Murray Whitwell. Thomas is going to be on the heads. Murray Whitwell on the heels. This team had a time of 13.54 on their first run. No joy there, unfortunately, for Thomas Whitwell. The young man ropes exceptionally well as a rule, but no joy there on that particular occasion. Let's go down to Norm Stagg, of course, for all your fencing product or all your fencing needs. Call Norm Stagg Fencing. Norm's proudly sponsored by his fencing firm. He's going to turn one around for Joe Birch. Norm Stagg here in the last round of the 11s around the corner. Joe Birch rides in with, oh goodness me, with a lovely heel loop and a time on the board of 7.05. Clean through the barrier, clean in the field, 7.05. Gee whiz, if only we'd have strung two of those together, gentlemen, you'd be back to the semi-finals for sure. Here's a young man calls Victoria home nowadays. Glenn Perkins going to turn one around for his wonderful partner in Wayne Slater. No stranger to the pay window, are they, in the team roping world, this particular team? Watch Wayne Slater ride in and set one. Goodness me, no time there on the back end. No joy. They were roping off a 9.32 in round number one. Currently leading the competition with a 13.60 here in rotation number six, Peter Hutchins and Shane Kenny. As we move down to William Thompson and Aaron Bookluck. They'll be followed by 183, Michael Reynolds and Andrew McQualter White. 184 will be Billy Guilford and Josh Symes. William Thomas. A big thank you to his support crew here. There's a time on the board in Southeast Vets at Mount Gambier, a time on the board of 7.83 plus 5 for a total of 12.83. Michael Reynolds, ladies and gentlemen, a wonderful custom saddler as a young man we're watching in the head box, proudly sponsored here by Mike Reynolds Custom Saddles. He's going to turn one around for Andrew McQualter White. Round the corner we go. They're going to be fast and slick too, but unfortunately no time on the board for Michael and Andrew. 184 in the draw will be next. Billy Guilford and Josh Symes. Both of these cowboys proudly sponsored by Guilford Transport. Here in rotation number six of the 11s competition. They're number 184 in the draw for everybody at home. And they'll be followed by 185 in Jacob and Todd Gaffey. Oh, goodness me, Billy Guilford, there's another man that will not leave you wondering. He threw it from the box, and unfortunately, no joy there for the team of Billy Guilford and Josh Symes. Jacob Gaffey and Todd Gaffey we watch right now. This team, ladies and gentlemen, were 9.74 on their first steer. Just be clean, gentlemen. Jacob nods his head and gets a black and white steer outside, but unfortunately no joy there for the Gaffey boys and a no time on the board. Let's go down now to a young lady that's Been very competitive in many legs of the rodeo world for many, many years. Southeast Queensland, she calls home. Tamara Knox is going to turn one around for the one and only Johnny Osborne. As we just saw earlier, one of the greats of the industry. Oh, goodness me. No. Unfortunately there for Tamara and Johnny, not a whole lot of joy there for the Evandale Arena production-sponsored cowboy on the back end. No time on the board for Tamara and Johnny. 187 in the draw. Mick Hockley and Warren Norton, you're up, gentlemen. You'll be followed by David Corr and Dale Caban. Bill Willoughby and Alan Woods in 189. 190, you'll then see Tony Hallam and Bruce Birch. Mick Hockley enters the arena, gets one on two horns around the corner for Warren Norton, waits his turn, takes a shot, puts the stretch and squeeze on. There's a time on the board. We're clean through the barrier and clean in the field for a 10.38 for Mick Hockley and Warren Norton. David Corr, you're going to turn one around next for Dale Caban, a young man in the heading box, ladies and gentlemen, calls North Queensland home up there around the Charters Towers country with the Emerald Cowboy on the back end in Dale Cave. And of course Dale was the big champion here last year at the Mitsubishi Big Show, took himself home a brand new Mitsubishi Triton. Gonna try and do the same thing right now. Nice job, David Corr. Oh goodness me, Dale Caban. Well, the old horseshoes and hand grenades thing rings true in that occasion. No time on the board for Corey and Cabes. Bill Willoughby, ladies and gentlemen, proudly sponsored by Willoughby Way Horsemanship. He's got one on there now for his partner in Alan Woods, who's once again very proudly sponsored by Alan Wood Livestock. But unfortunately there for our South Australian header, no joy with that head loop and a no time on the board. Let's go down to two of the gentlemen in the sport of team roping, Tony Hallam and Bruce Birch. Lovely loop on. Come on, Bruce Birch. Waits his shot, takes his shot. Well, goodness me. I tell you what, I'm not sure what else could have happened to make that work, but unfortunately no time for the team of Tony Hallam and Bruce Birch. Clint Litchfield, proudly sponsored by Litchfield Horizontal Boring. He's going to walk in the head box and turn one around for one of the great headers of the country, Heath Litchfield. Numerous time Australian champion on the heels on this occasion. Clint takes his steer around the corner. Hey, that's what we like to see, Heath Litchfield. There's a time on the board of 7.66. 7.66, that's what we like to see from the champion cowboy in Heath Litchfield. Here's the winner of the Opens competition last night, ladies and gentlemen, Jeff Miller. He's going to turn one around for the young man who won two motor cars at the tender age of 14 years of age in the year of 2015, Mr. Darcy Kirsch. Of course, Darcy and all the Kirsch family very proudly sponsored by Proper Caps and Apparel here this year at the Mitsubishi Big Show. Jeffrey Miller run. Oh, well, goodness me, it happens to the best of the best. The best of the best, and unfortunately, no time there for Jeff and Darcy. Let's go down to a young lady that we've all grown to love here in downtown Tamworth at the Mitsubishi Big Show, Ella Mitchell. Ladies and gentlemen, this young girl has travelled 3,500 kilometres to join us here this week. She calls Esperance in Western Australia home, and she's going to turn one round for Jace Land. Make no mistake, this young lady is rising through the team roping ranks, and we love having her over here in Tamworth each and every year. Lots of likes on Facebook there for Ella Mitchell. There you go, Ella. You get the most likes on Facebook of anybody that's watching out there. Wonderful to have you along, and a big thank you to Jace and his sponsor in Long Pocket Earth Moving. James Maguire Spalding, ladies and gentlemen, going to turn one around right now for David Brown. James Maguire Spalding, of course, grew up in a very famous rodeo family. It's our pleasure to have him here at the big show this year. This particular team is riding in the second round, coming off a number of a 7.21 second run in round number one. Is this going to be the fastest team of the rotation so far, as David Brown rides in, sets a trap? Oh yeah, 7.78 to go on top of their 7.21. For a 14.99 at this stage of the rotation, puts them into second place of the rotation. They look like they're a red hot chance to come back to the semi-finals here in the 11's competition. Mick Carney, ladies and gentlemen, he calls the Camden district in New South Wales home. Should be in there right now with Campbell Hodson. It should be Mick Carney and Campbell Hodson. We need number 195 in the draw, Mick Carney, Campbell Hodson. Then they'll be followed by Mal Fishenden and Andrew Lynch. We'll then look for Clint Vandenbroek and Clinton Slater. Mick Carney, the NCI-sponsored cowboy, around the corner, wants some round money. Campbell Hodson, one of the fine young team ropers on the back end. There's one, there's two. 6.52 for Mick and Campbell. Could end up with some fast money out of the rotation yet. 6.52. That's the fastest time of this round. As we move down to Mal Fishenden and the Red River sponsored cowboy and Andrew Lynch. Andrew Lynch is on the head, Mal Fishenden on the heels. This young man, ladies and gentlemen, was first, second, third high team last year here at the big show coming into the finals. Andrew Lynch, a big thank you to Red River. Mal Fishenden gets one on. We get ourselves a qualified run, plus five. Plus five in the field and plus five in the barrier. A 10.92, plus five, plus five for 20. Oh, hang on. Andrew Lynch and Mal Fishenden, you are clean on the barrier. You're a 15.92. 15.92 to go on top of your 14.76 for a 30.68. Clint Vandenbroek, ladies and gentlemen, and Clinton Slater. Around the corner we go. I do apologize to Andrew Lynch and Mal Fishenden. There's a team on the bounty steer, ladies and gentlemen. They've got to be sub 8 seconds. We're going to get a little bit more movement. You've got to ride him forward, Clint, to get a little bit. Oh, boy. A little bit of a tough one there in the playpen. The boys end up with a no time. 30, yeah, so a time for Mal Fishenden and Andrew Lynch was 30.68 on two after two. There's still a big show to come back in the semi-finals at the completion of round number of rotation six. Gene Hingston, Dusty Tatum, you're up, gentlemen, in 198, and thank you for your patience. Gene Hingston, Dusty Tatum are up. They'll be followed by Wendy Caven and Peter Todd Sr. We'll then look for Alex Campbell and Matthew Mapp. Following Gene and Dusty, we'll get Wendy and Peter Todd Sr. We'll then look for Alex Campbell and Matthew Mapp in 200. 201 will be Casey Tribe and Steve Sutherland. Oh, gee whiz. No joy there, unfortunately, for Gene Hinks. He's travelled many miles to be here. He's a wonderful supporter of the big show. We love to see him here each and every year. We're sure he'll be back in 2018 as well. This is what it's all about. This is team roping on the biggest stage in the Southern Hemisphere. There's no doubt about that. The Mitsubishi Big Show. Here she is, Wendy Caben. We'll give you a run now, Wendy, if that's all right. Wendy is going to turn one around for Peter Todd Sr. You're on a bounty steer as well, Wendy. On a bounty steer. So if this team's under 8 seconds Oh, goodness me. Well, that looked like a beautiful head loop there from Wendy Caban. But unfortunately, no joy. No time on the board. Let's go to Alex Campbell and Matthew Mapp. You're up, gentlemen, in 200. You'll be followed by Casey Tribe and Steve Sutherland in 201. We'll then look for Natalie and Heath Kimber in 202. Tony Lilliman and Paul Hunkin, please be ready. Alex Campbell, 1, 2, 3, out and around the corner. Oh, goodness me, Matthew Mapp, he's got the ability to do it too. He roped him on the corner. They were going to come back with one on after two out. Make no mistake if that had a stuck. But unfortunately, it didn't, and there's a no time on the board. The next particular team in 201 in the draw was 14.57 at the completion of round number one, Casey Tribe and Steve Sutherland. Here's a very consistent pair. Steve Sutherland, get in there and get your one, is going to do 7.98 plus 5. 7.98 and 5 for 12.98 gives them a two-round total of 27.55. Okay. Seven runs left for Matthew Mons down the back. Seven runs. Heath Kimber and Natalie Kimber. Of course, Natalie backs into the heading box. She's going to turn one around for Heath Kimber on the back end on this particular combination. They were 13.04 at the completion of round number one. Lots of Facebook likes too for Natalie Kimber and Heath Kimber. Go on, Gouge, get down there and get yourself some red meat. That's what we like to see. 10.55. 10.55 on top of their 13.04 for a two-round time of 23.59. 23 and 59. Tony Lilliman and Paul Hunkin, both very proudly sponsored by the Cattle Creek Cattle Company. They were 16.97 on their first steer. Doob gets one on. It wasn't pretty, but it's on there. A bit like one of my golf shots when it works. Oh, goodness me, Paul Hunkin, no joy on the back end after your man finally got it on the horns. They had a 16.97 in the first. Nothing to speak of in number two. They leave the arena with a no time. Adam Bates. Very proudly sponsored by his good friend and Brett Peel Equine, of course, one of the leading cutting horse trainers here in New South Wales. Going to turn one around for the HD helicopter sponsored cowboy and Liam Davison. Oh no. Adam Bates looks down and says, seriously? They were 6.65 on their first deer, and I so wanted them to get another clean run on the board to have them back into the semi-finals of the 11s, but no time, unfortunately. As Gary King and Lee Kimber make their way in. Gary's joined us from as far south as you can get, and a big thank you to Gary, proudly sponsored by Tasman Horse Transport. We're going to talk to Gary King later on throughout the program, ladies and gentlemen, on Facebook and get some of his thoughts. He's travelled thousands of k's to be here, and we thoroughly enjoy having him as well. Joe Raines and Brady Moss, ladies and gentlemen, here's a team to watch for the fast money. Of course, Brody Moss, very proudly sponsored by Joe Slade. Oh, yeah, on there they go, Joe Raines, Brody Moss, 6.09, clean everywhere. Well done, gentlemen, a pleasure to watch. Thank you for the entertainment. A 6.09 at this stage is going to be the fast time of the rotation and fast time of the round. Roger York and Pete Slater are number nine's incentive team. Lots of likes on Facebook for the last team. Lots and lots and lots of likes for Joe Raines and Brody Moss. That's all the girls in the world, I would have thought. They think old Joe Raines and old Brody Moss are a little bit of all right. Roger York, come on, Yorkie, get him on around the corner. Peter Salter waits his shot. gets the tip working, gets it in there. There's the stretch and squeeze, to quote the great Larry Cairn, for a 10.25. A 10.25 on one after two. Unfortunately, therefore, Roger and Pete, you also incurred a 5 second speeding fine at the barrier for a 15.25, a 15 and a quarter. Here's the final team out for the number 11's roping, ladies and gentlemen. Here's Daly Tilts and Robbie White Jr. Daly gets one out there and on around the corner for his young partner in Robbie White Jr. Oh yeah, nice looking loop, son. Get him stretched, boys, a 9.81. They were clean in the barrier and clean on the field. They had themselves a 16.34 on their first steer and a 9.81 for a two-round time of 26.16. Well, ladies and gentlemen, that does wind down the whole preliminary roping of the number 11's competition here at the Mitsubishi Big Show. A big thank you to Can-Am and all our sponsors here in the number 11's competition. Well, ladies and gentlemen, I'm now going to hand you back over to Big Screens Australia. We're going to see you back here in an hour's time for the beginning of rotation number one of the number eight competition. So at 12:30 sharp, we will be clearing the arena to get ready with the Mitsubishi Big Show's number eight competition here at the ALEC Arena in Tamworth 2017. Thank you very, very much. We'll see you in an hour.